weather gives us some really good metaphors for talking about our mood. So you can talk about having a sunny disposition, you can talk about your relationship being stormy, you can talk about your future being under a cloud. But does the weather actually affect our mood? The aspects of weather that seem to affect mood most are probably sun and heat. Of course, rainy weather will also tend to depress people's moods, but the amount of sun and the amount of heat are the main determinants. And of course, sun primarily creates more positive moods and creates a sense of vitality. When it's sunny, we tend to be more likely to be active and to be going out and doing things and sharing experiences with others. So to some extent, it's just a social phenomenon. But also there's a biological side to it. So when you are exposed to sunlight, that produces vitamin D, and vitamin D promotes the production of serotonin, a brain chemical that helps to regulate and elevate our mood as well. Some people just don't have enough sun exposure and are prone to seasonal affective disorder, which is a kind of depression that comes about mainly in the winter months, especially if you're living a long way from the equator. One of the interesting things about effects of weather on mood is that anything that improves our mood tends to change our behaviour. So for instance, when people are in positive moods, they tend to be more helpful. And there are studies showing that on sunny days, people are more likely to tip waiters and waitresses better. They're more likely to help strangers who are in need. They're more likely to respond positively to attempts to be picked up. Negative moods created by gloomy weather can have an effect as well. So a study by Sabrina Bryneal and colleagues in Belgium showed that people were more likely to play the lottery on gloomy days. So it seems when people are in a negative mood state created by gloomy weather, they'll try to find a way out of it. There are very large differences between people in how susceptible they are to sun. For instance, in their mood. And we don't really know what causes that. It doesn't seem to be related to people's general personality. It's not that introverts are happier in gloomy weather or extroverts are happier in sunlight. Some people just are more susceptible, not only to everyday fluctuations in weather, but also seasonal fluctuations in weather. The way to benefit from weather is to be out in it. So when it's good weather, people have found that you actually don't reap any mood benefits from sunny days unless you spend at least 30 minutes outside. People tend to mistake their current emotional state for their general satisfaction with life. So on cloudy days, they tend to think their life is worse than on sunny days.
The U.S. National Library of Medicine notes that some people experience a serious mood change when the seasons change. They may sleep too much, have little energy, and may also feel depressed. Though symptoms can be severe, they usually clear up. The condition in the summer can include heightened anxiety. SAD was formally described and named in 1984 by Norman E. Rosenthal and colleagues at the National Institute of Mental Health. There are many treatments for classic, winter-based, seasonal affective disorder. SAD is a type of major depressive disorder, and sufferers may exhibit any of the associated symptoms, such as feelings of hopelessness and worthlessness, thoughts of suicide, loss of interest in activities, withdrawal from social interaction, sleep and appetite problems, difficulty with concentration and decisions, decreased sex drive, a lack of energy, or agitation. Symptoms of winter SAD often include oversleeping or difficulty waking up in the morning, nausea, and a tendency to overeat, often with a craving for carbohydrates, which leads to weight gain. SAD is typically associated with winter depression.